everybody. Welcome back to Durbin's Bourbon. I'm Joe.
And I'm Josh.
We're doing a blind shootout between two heavy hitters made by the Buffalo Trace Distillery in Frankfort, Kentucky. The one on the left is Blanton's, and the one on the right is Elmer T. Lee. Both whiskeys are single barrel products. And they have their hype, and the going price right now, if you're going to pay suggested retail, Blanton's is a $60 bottle of bourbon. Yes, if you go out there in the secondary market, I have seen it as high as $350 a bottle, which is absurd. Yeah. Please don't pay that for the whiskey. It's not worth that. It really isn't. It is a great whiskey. It's a single barrel, just like the Elmer T. Lee, and it's commanding some high prices as well.
The Elmer T.
As well. Yeah, both of them are commanding pretty high prices on the secondary market. Regular price for Elmer T. actually is quite a bit less than Blanton's for suggested retail. It's around $40, I think. Last time I bought this bottle, I think it was right under 40. Okay. We're going back a couple, maybe a year or so, I think, when I got this last bottle. Suggested retail. It may have increased a little bit by now. I'm guessing it probably has. Both are good products. Both have a long history. Both are at a very famous and storied distillery in Kentucky. Proof-wise, your Blanton's is coming in at 93 proof, doggone it. I thought that was 93 proof.
This is 90.
So, there you go. It's just a quick review. It's a blind.
Kind of a fun thing we just thought we'd throw together.
Yeah, and we like these blinds. It really tells you where you're at, where your palate is for that day.
So, I'm assuming we'll just go the inside one is one and then this one's two.
Sure.
For our little notes.
Yep.
I'm gonna go. I already nose mine, but go for deep nose.
Inside.
Deep nose inside. Ah, it smells like delicious caramel. A lot of cherry on mine.
Yeah. There's vanilla, caramel, brown sugar.
Oh, I get that really dark cherry.
I can see a dark cherry note even on this one. Color wise. Both have a decent color to them. Your Blanton's is around a 7 to 8 year whiskey.
I really like the nose on that. That almost smells like it was aged in poor wine barrel. I know because neither of these are, but. And this one.
Say, that nose is good. Number one.
I think I could pick what they are just on the nose. I'll reveal that at the end.
Caramel, vanilla.
But this one's got.
Sugar.
More of a wood, like a grain wood for me. And ours, we poured each other, so we don't know what's what. So
yeah, I think I.
Right, you can tell by the nose, right? I'm thinking I can.
I have a sneaky suspicion.
Right. Like for me, just on the nose, just for right now, I would say this is Blanton's and this is Elmer T. But I don't want to know yet. I want to wait until. So my one, I would say, is Blanton's. Just on the nose.
And see,
this is Elmer T.
And see, I am going to say number two for me is probably the Blanton's. So, has a vanilla, but it has more oak. Number two, oak forward.
Yeah, my number two is very vanilla. Char, but like more of like a green, not green like whiskey, like a young whiskey, but like grain, wood, and vanilla note.
Okay, you're number two. Yeah.
Yeah. Really just, a strong wood characteristic in that. And then this one's got a more, almost maple-y.
This one's soft. This one is oak forward, vanilla, but there's a greenish note.
I'm ready to go.
I'm not really green. I'm going to go to the number one.
I'm going to my number one. Cheers.
Cheers, everybody.
kind of the
same. Boy, that's good.
It's got a lot of the same characteristics as the nose. Almost like cherry. I got mine at least has a dark cherry note to it. It's very distinct. Which I don't remember having in either of these.
No.
There's such a sweetness to it. That's crazy.
Boy, what is that? That number one I just tasted.
That's good.
There's an alcohol burn. Alcohol burn. Some oak on the palate. Vanilla.
I'm getting what you're describing in this one. I should have got some. Did you this one first?
Yeah, number one.
And that one in my number two, because I just tasted my number two.
Oh, okay.
A lot of oak, a lot of vanilla on the nose as well as on the palate.
Yeah.
But this one's got some serious cherry notes. It's like almost...
I didn't get water for this.
Want a sip of mine?
Sure, buddy.
Just careful. You see where I sipped it because of the chapstick ring.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of healthy lips.
Oh, yeah. Clean up the palate a little bit. Boy.
That's hard to decide which one's which, only because I don't drink a lot of Elmer T. Lee because I have like this much left in my bottle. Correct. From 7 years ago.
Right.
But I think I can choose just because I drink enough Blantons here and there.
Mm-hmm. The one I thought it was, now after the taste is confusing me a little bit.
It does, right? That same
year. Number two is soft. It's a soft, approachable bourbon. Soft nose. I think, yeah, I'm going to soft. There's that vanilla. Both of them are made by Buffalo Trace. The mash bill is very similar. It is a rye mash bill, so you have corn, rye, and barley. Blanton's, as you all know, that if you're a big Blanton's fan, it comes from Warehouse H only. Elmer T. Lee is brought out of, I believe, a few different warehouses. They just pick it based on flavor profile. I may be mistaken on the warehouses, but I think Elmer T. does come out of a couple different warehouses.
I think so, too.
They just basically go for profile only. If that barrel has the profile, they run with it. I'd have to say, for both of them, I enjoy both of them.
I think they're both very good.
Both really
there's
good.
Different. They're different, though.
They are for they're pretty single distinct, barrels.
Yeah.
When you have a similar mash bill based from the same original White Dog, which produces these, it's interesting how much the oak changes.
And the age, I don't know what the age is. I think Blanton's is at least 8, right?
It is. It's running around 8. And Elmer T. Lee is in the same ballpark. I mean, they are a 6 to 8 year old bourbon as well. So you've got a similar profile as far as age, where they're at in the warehouse, different, the same warehouse always, and varied warehouses, but the profile is probably going to be the same, close to the standard.
All right. Well, I know I'm ready to pick mine.
Are you? Do you have a favorite?
Yeah, I have a favorite. Not a hands down definite, this is my favorite, because it's to me, this one was sweeter. And I usually like the more oaky ones, but...
You do like that.
There's a weird cherry note to this that I just really enjoy.
Boy, I will have to say number one is a richer flavor.
Same with my number one.
Richer flavor.
It's got this deep cherry note.
The number one?
Yeah.
Interesting. I'm torn. They're almost 50-50 for me. Mm-hmm. One is a stronger, bolder flavor, which for me is number one. Number one is bolder, has more oak. The other one is softer and a little bit more approachable. Hints of oak, hints of vanilla, but everything's more soft and subdued.
And so my number one is sweeter, but there's more, to me, there's more going on in it. There's more flavors. There's honey, caramel. You get that heavy cherry note, like dark cherry, candy cherry. Geez, almost like apricot. There's just a lot going on. Like almost, yeah, I get a lot on that one. This one, I get oak, honey, a little bit of caramel. It's almost like dry.
Yeah.
Like a dry char to it. It's good, really good, but I would say my number one is my favorite. My number two is my second favorite. And if I had to guess, I'd say my number one is Blanton's. My number two is Elmer.
Okay.
There you have it.
Boy, that's so tough.
They're both really good.
Yeah. You know. I think my number two at this point right now, it's so close. I'm favoring the softer notes of number two.
Okay.
One is more bold and strong. I feel like number two is Blanton's.
Okay. And two's your favorite of the two? Like a 51-49 split?
Probably. Maybe?
Or do you not have a favorite?
That's so tough because they're close but yet different. So I appreciate them both on this almost the same level.
Yeah. And same with mine. I do have out of the two right now, I prefer my number one.
Actually, the nose though tells me that number one is probably Blanton's.
I forgot about let's see this nose.
Single barrel. Barrels are a tough animal.
Yeah.
I'm just going to stick with it.
Crack.
I mean, if you're wrong, you have a 50-50 chance of being right.
It doesn't matter.
It really doesn't.
They're both good and we get to drink two good whiskeys. Okay, so if you had to choose, do you have a favorite?
Right now, I think it's going to be number... Yeah. Number two.
Number two's your favorite?
Yeah. It's softer for whatever reason.
So two's your favorite. One's your second favorite. And then what do you think they are?
I feel like I'm wrong actually saying this. I really do.
Okay.
But I'm going to stick with my initial.
Okay.
I think number two is Blanton's.
Okay.
And which leaves number one is Elmer T.
So you had, actually was reversed. This is Blanton's, that's Elmer.
Okay.
And what are mine? Because I thought this was Blanton's and that was Elmer.
It's reversed.
Really? So we both thought, that's funny that.
Because I made a note for me. I poured Elmer T. Blanton's. Oh, actually, Blanton's is in Woodford.
So I got it right.
You got it right. I got it wrong.
Liar.
I had to look at my note.
Mess with my emotions, Smokey. let me see something real quick. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So, like, by the nose, like the Blanton's, I know that nose because I drink more Blanton's.
Right.
You know, and so I just kind of went with what I know, but I've never got that cherry note to it. No. I wonder if that's a different single barrel than what I have.
It probably is.
But it is. I got a super strong cherry note to it.
And I even though I said I was like, I think this is Blanton's, but this one was bolder and richer.
Yeah.
I'm like, it's almost like I felt it should be Blanton's if it's not.
Blanton's.
And I should have went with my...
When you said that after the nose, you're like, oh, maybe that might be Blanton's. I was like, oh, you probably got it now.
I should have stuck with my secondary gut.
The woodiness of this one, I felt like the few times that I've had Elmer T, I remember it being like a high rye, like a woody, grassy.
Right.
And that's what I get in that.
So, yeah. Mm. So...
Well, there you have it.
I enjoyed, in this particular round, I enjoyed the Elmer T. Lee slightly more.
You did?
I did.
And you usually don't because it's high rye.
Correct. I usually don't. But this is an older bottle. Yeah. It's been sitting oxidizing for a couple years
probably. It is good, too.
It's a good bourbon. Mm-hmm. Both great bourbons, great distillery. If you're in Kentucky, swing by and do a tour. Any of the tours are great. They do have their bottles they put out on their shelves in the distillery at suggested retail. So you can walk in there and buy bottles of Blanton's.
It's a bottle.
Yeah, it's one per customer per day.
Whatever they have that day. That's so cool, man.
And when they're running Elmer T, or if they're running Blanton's or Eagle Rare, it's whatever they're running. They stock it on the shelves. So there you have it. Whiskey review, single barrel bourbons out of Kentucky, Frankfort, Buffalo Trace, Elmer T. Lee. Blanton's.
I stroked out there for a second.
It was close. From Durbin's Bourbon, we hope you enjoyed this video and this review. Remember to hit that thumbs up, like, and subscribe. Please subscribe. It doesn't cost you anything. Helps us grow as a channel. I got nothing else.
Yeah.
We'll wrap this one up. As always, enjoy your whiskeys and bourbons.
Any way you like.
Cheers, everybody. Cheers, buddy.
Cheers, pal.